be chapter 5. This will be video 7. Today we'll be discussing the prevention of water pollution, floods and drought. First, the prevention of water pollution. For preventing water pollution, first we'll cover the pollution coming from the industries and factories. Whatever pollution is coming from the industries and factories which is added into the water, the contaminants and harmful substances which are added into the water, before adding those into the water, we can do the pre-treatment of the industrial waste. जो भी गंदा पानी, harmful polluted water हमने industries या factories से release करना है water bodies में, before releasing that contaminated water, those pollutants, we can treat the water to remove any harmful, toxic and poisonous substances out of it. So that जो भी पानी हम बाहर अब release करेंगे industry से, it will be harmless. Second, using appropriate amount of fertilizers and other chemicals such as pesticides and insecticides. Yesterday we discussed कि जो भी fertilizers, insecticides etc. use होते हैं हमारे fields में, they can go into the water table along with the rainwater through infiltration, or they can run off into the nearby water bodies. And these cause water pollution, these cause algal bloom and other problems. So if we are using appropriate amount of fertilizers and other chemicals in the fields, we can avoid this problem. Then comes proper sewage treatment. जो भी sewage produce हुआ है through the towns, cities, villages etc. Before releasing this sewage water into the water bodies, it should be properly treated to remove the harmful contaminates out of it. Then we studied about mixing of excreta, whether human or animal, into the water. This was the main cause of waterborne diseases. So we can avoid the mixing of human and animal wastes in water by using proper sanitation facilities. Then prohibiting the direct dumping of garbage or any other harmful substance or waste substance inside the water. We notice many times near the water bodies there are plastic bags, plastic bottles lying, other garbage from other garbage lying, and this should be avoided. Then containing and preventing oil spill in oceans. Oil spill is a phenomena whenever the commercial ships carry tankers of oil from one country to another, mostly from the Gulf countries to rest of the countries of the world. There is a concept of oil spill. जब commercial ships Gulf countries से दूसरे countries तक oil, petroleum ये सब चीज़ें carry करते हैं, sometimes these ships become damaged, they may sink, or there might be some accident. और जो कंटेनर का ऑयल है जो शिप्स कैरी कर रहे थे, इट माइट स्पिल ऑन टू द ओशियंस. दिस इज वन ऑफ द रीजंस ऑफ वाटर पॉल्यूशन एज वेल, एंड वी शुड बी टेकिंग स्टेप्स फॉर प्रिवेंटिंग इट, बिकॉज ऑयल स्पिल क्रिएट्स अ लेयर ऑफ ऑयल ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द वाटर. हमें पता है ऑयल डज नॉट डिसॉल्व इन वाटर, ऑयल पानी के ऊपर तैरता है. दीज ऑयल स्पिल्स कवर द सर्फेस ऑफ वाटर, they prevent oxygen from being added into the water, they prevent the respiration of aquatic plants and animals inside that water, and also it acts as a pollutant inside the water. The next topic is flood. Now what is a flood? Flood is a natural phenomena caused by rain और हैवी रेन इन सर्टेन एरियाज. जब बहुत ज़्यादा बारिश, थंडरस्टॉर्म्स या मेल्टिंग ऑफ स्नो हो जाती है, स्पेशली इन द माउंटेनियस रीजन्स, अ फ्लड अकर्स. जब बहुत ज़्यादा बारिश होती है, मोर देन नॉर्मल, मोर देन नेसेसरी, इट कैन कॉज टू फ्लडिंग. एवरी ईयर इन इंडिया वी हैव फ्लड्स इन सर्टेन पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया, स्पेशली इन साउथ इंडिया एंड टूवर्ड्स द east of India in the states of Bihar, Bengal, Assam, etc. Now, when floods happen, there is a overrun of water from the rivers. जो भी river का पानी है या आसपास की water की bodies का पानी है वो overrun होता है आसपास के land areas में. And these areas get immersed in water. जो पानी overflow होगा, जो excessive rain आ रही है, जो भी पानी जमा होता जा रहा है, it will cause damage to the land area of that particular area where it is happening. The fields might get submerged, जो खेत है, जो लोगों के घर हैं, the roads, the cities can get submerged in water. The water can come in high pressure, high speeds, and it can carry along objects like houses, cars, furniture, etc. Now, what are the impacts or effects of floods? First, it causes human loss. People can die during floods. They can drown in the flood water and die. Their houses or cars or other belongings can get carried off along with the people and great damage may occur. Again, flood causes the damage to crops, animals and human lives. Loss of property. For example, fields, houses, etc. Then effects on the major roads. There is water logging on the roads. Roads mein pani jama ho jata hai. They cannot be used and hence there is effect on the roads. Disruption of air, train and bus services. When there is heavy rain, jab bahut zyada barish ho rahi hai and there is flooding, the roads cannot be used, the railway systems cannot be used and the air transports cannot be used. Then spread of waterborne communicable diseases. Whenever there is flooding and water logging, जब भी flooding होती है, बाढ़ आ जाती है और water logging होती है, the water sources get mixed with the sewage. जो water sources हैं हमारे, the river, the lake, the underground water, etc. वो sewage, raw sewage, untreated sewage के साथ mix हो जाते हैं, and it causes the spread of waterborne diseases. Other than that, there is also an increase in the number of insects such as flies and mosquitoes during floods and after floods. This causes the spread of diseases like cholera, typhoid, malaria, etc. One more problem which we have, whenever animals or people drown and die in flood water, their bodies decompose over there and they also attract pathogens which cause diseases. Next comes communication breakdown. The mobile towers, the telephone lines, or the electricity supply, all these things are affected during the floods. Economic and social disruptions. The people cannot go to work, their houses are damaged, their vehicles are damaged, the fields get submerged, the crops get destroyed. So this causes economical and social disruption. And also scarcity of drinking water. जब हमारे water sources sewage के साथ mix हो जाते हैं, then there is a shortage of drinkable water. The next is drought. Drought is the exact opposite in a way of flood. Flood में बारिश बहुत ज़्यादा होती है, water logging हो जाती है, जो water sources, water body का water है, वो overflow होता है towards the land areas and residential areas. Droughts mein barish kam hoti hai. There it is a period of time when there is no or very little rain. Again, too much rain can cause damage to crops and plants. The lack of rain, jo barish ki kami hai, it also does the same thing. It affects and destroys the crops and plants of the area. Since there is no rain water, the water bodies have not been replenished, water bodies recharge nahi hui hai, koi barish nahi ho rahi hai. So there is a shortage of water for everyone including animals, plants and humans. Due to this, the crops may dry up, fasle sook jati hai, the price of food items in this case goes up, there may be a shortage of water, there will be a shortage of food. Then the effects of drought. First is the crop yield becomes less. Economic impact ये है जो agriculture activities हैं, the farming activities, the crops dry off and the crop yield जो उपज थी crops की वो कम हो जाती है. The soil dry up as it continues to lose water by evaporation. जो soil के अंदर water है, moisture है, it starts decreasing. The soil dries up. जब soil सूख जाता है, जब उसमें पानी नहीं होता, the crops cannot grow. This leads to shortage of crops, destruction of crops and unemployment for the farmers as well. Then environmental impact. Insect infestations and plant diseases increase. Plants जब खराब होने लगते हैं, सूखने लगते हैं, तो इंसेक्ट्स उनमें फीड करना शुरू कर देते हैं. सॉइल इरोशन इंक्रीजेस. द प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन दैट एरिया गेट अफेक्टेड ड्यू टू द शॉर्टेज ऑफ वाटर. ओवर टाइम डेसर्टिफिकेशन टेक्स प्लेस, यानी कि अगर ड्रॉट कई सालों तक कंटिन्यू रहेगी तो वो जगह डेजर्ट में चेंज हो जाएगी. लैक ऑफ वाटर कॉजेस द डेथ ऑफ लाइफ स्टॉक. जो एनिमल्स हमने पाले हुए हैं, द कैटल एक्सेट्रा, दे कैन डाई बिकॉज ऑफ लैक ऑफ वाटर. शॉर्टेज ऑफ वाटर ऑल्सो कॉजेज द डेथ ऑफ पीपल. एंड देन डिहाइड्रेशन एंड अदर रिलेटेड डिजीजेज आर ऑल्सो कॉमन. पीपल गेट डिहाइड्रेटेड कॉन्स्टेंटली बिकॉज वाटर इज नॉट अवेलेबल फॉर देम टू ड्रिंक. देन द सोशल इम्पैक्ट. Social impact is there are frequent disputes between the people for the availability of water. पानी कम है इसलिए पानी के पीछे disputes या arguments, लड़ाई ज़्यादा होती है लोगों के बीच में. There is an unequal water distribution between the people. The people who are rich who can afford water, they can have it easily, but the people who are poor, they have problem acquiring the water. For example, the people living in village areas, for example, have to travel long distances to get the water from some water body, which I have shown in the picture before the slide, or from a well, etc. Other than that, the people in a drought affected area may also have to migrate. जो पुअर लोग हैं जिनको फूड अवेलेबल नहीं हो रहा, वाटर अवेलेबल नहीं हो रहा, दे हैव टू लीव देयर हाउसेस एंड गो टू अदर स्टेट्स, अदर सिटीज, एंड दिस माइट लीड टू अ इकोनॉमिकल डिस्पैरिटी. दिस विल बी इट फॉर टुडे. टुमारो वील बी डिस्कसिंग द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ वाटर एंड रेन वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग.